criminal. You know, I always thought it was the cost of the prescription, but it's really the cost of the pharmacy. And I would have never known that if I didn't have insurance.
That's Melissa Gumpf. She was briefly without insurance when she still greatly needed it, like so many other Americans. Facing expensive prescription costs, she discovered the price from pharmacy to pharmacy varied tremendously. Looking for answers, Daniel Dwyer shows us the price Melissa had to pay and how you can save yourself time and money when it comes to your medications.
When Melissa Gumpf and her family moved back to Ohio from Wyoming, she encountered a problem.
We had a brief period where we didn't have insurance, and I went to fill them, and the cost for one of them was $400, the other one was $700, and I mean, nobody can do that.
Melissa has epilepsy, making her three prescriptions vital.
I had to buy 4 days worth for like $100 and some odd, and then, you know, I couldn't do that anymore. So I had to go a while without it.
That's when Melissa turned to her doctor for answers. He introduced her to the website GoodRx.
All you have to do is type in the medication, your location, and it'll give you the cost of all the pharmacies around.
When her doctor did this, to Melissa's surprise, she discovered she could fill her prescriptions at Costco for just $38 versus the hundreds she was originally told at a different pharmacy. In fact, the 4 days' worth of pills she bought to get by was nearly triple what the entire refill would have cost. But the financial burden wasn't her only frustration.
You have to be seizure-free for so long before you can have a driver's license again.
Melissa was just 3 months away from having a driver's license again. Being a mom of two, she wants the ease and flexibility of being able to drive herself around. But now she's back at square one.
That's where the anger came from, when I found out just how outrageously different the cost was. I just always thought it was just the cost of, you know, the drug that you're on.
That's not the case at all. Erin Langle, assistant professor of pharmacy practice at the University of Toledo, says there's multiple other factors involved in prescription pricing.
So depending on that pharmacy, who they use as a wholesaler, who that wholesaler used, what companies that they bought product from, you can get a large variation from company to company using different wholesalers or even buying products at different times.
As Langle points out, supply and demand play a big role as well. And besides websites like GoodRx, he encourages people to have a discussion with their pharmacists if they're in a bind.
We view ourselves as the medication experts, and we are the side that wants to ideally help people get the best outcomes from their medications. Asking that pharmacist, this is what we're treating. What are there cheaper alternatives that you're aware of?
While she had to learn the hard way, Melissa says she takes comfort in now knowing her options.
Well, I think just the comfort part of knowing that it doesn't have to be that expensive. You know, if something were to happen to insurance down the line, that, you know, I'm not going to have that problem anymore.
Reporting tonight, Danielle Dwyer, WTOL 11.